गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द थर्ड चैप्टर ऑफ बिहाइव द लिटिल गर्ल. बिफोर यू रीड, डू यू फील यू नो योर पेरेंट्स बेटर नाउ देन व्हेन यू वर मच यंगर? परहैप्स यू नाउ अंडरस्टैंड द रीजंस फॉर सम ऑफ देयर एक्शंस दैट यूज्ड टू अपसेट यू अर्लियर. सो ऑब्वियसली यू माइट बी अंडरस्टैंडिंग योर पेरेंट्स मच बेटर नाउ. Okay, you know that whatever your actions has been taken by your parents are for your benefit. The story about a little girl whose feelings for her father change from fear to understanding will probably find an echo in every room. To the little girl, he was a figure to be feared and avoided. So for Kezia, for the little girl, her father was a figure of fear. Means she was scared to look at her father, and she always just liked to avoid her father. Every morning before going to work, he came into her room and gave her a casual kiss, to which she responded with goodbye father. Okay, so every morning her father used to come to her room and he used to just give a casual kiss, to which Kezia responded every time that goodbye father. And oh, there was a glad sense of relief when she heard the noise of the carriage growing fainter and fainter down the long road. Okay, so she feel very much relaxed, very much relieved when she used to heard the noise of the carriage was just growing faint and faint on the long road. That shows that yes, her father has gone to office. In the evening when he came home, she stood near the staircase and heard his loud voice in the hall. So when he just returned from the office, so she used to heard his voice very loudly in the hall. Bring my tea into the drawing room. Hasn't the paper come yet? Mother, go and see if my papers out there and bring me my slippers. Kezia, mother would call to her, if you are a good girl, you can come down and take off father's boots. Slowly the girl would slip down the stairs, more slowly still across the hall, and pushed open the drawing room door. So when her father used to come, he used to shout for the tea and for the paper, okay, and he used to just shout to bring his slippers. And Kezia's mother would just call her from the upstairs, and she just says that if you are a good girl, come down and just take off your father's boots. But Kezia was very much afraid of her father. She just slipped down, means she used to come very slowly. And she just came across the hall and push open, and she used to just open the drawing room door. By that time, he had his spectacles on and looked at her over them in a way that was terrifying to the little girl. So by the time when she used to come, or when she used to just enter the drawing room, at that time, the father had his spectacles on, or was had the spectacles on his eyes, and the way he used to look just make Kezia very much terrified. Well, Kezia, hurry up and pull off these boots and take them outside. Have you been a good girl today? So he just asked Kezia to hurry down and to just take off his boots, okay, and to just keep them outside. And he just asked that whether she was a good girl or not that day or not. But Kezia was very much afraid, so she used to stammer, I don't know father. You don't know? If you stutter like that, mother will have to take you to doctor. Stutter means you stammer. So what father used to say, that if you're going to stammer like this, mother will just take you to the doctor. She never stuttered with other people, had quite given it up, but only with father. because then she was trying so hard to say the words properly. So she never used to stammer in front of the other people except father. It was very difficult for her to take out the words in front of her father. What's the matter? What are you looking so rushed about? Mother, I wish you taught this girl not to appear on the brink of suicide. Here, Kezia, carry my teacup back to the table carefully. Okay. So, used to ask her, what's the matter? Why looking so upset? Okay. And he would just instruct Kezia to bring the teacup very carefully. He was so big, his arm, his hands and his neck, especially his mouth, when he yawned. Thinking about him alone was like thinking about a giant. So what Kezia was saying, that she was a little girl, okay? So when she used to look at her father, she used to just say that he was really very big, his hands are very big and neck, and when he used to yawn, his mouth seems to be very big. And so she says that he was not less than a giant. On Sunday afternoons, grandmother sent her down to the drawing room to have a nice talk with father and mother. So on Sunday afternoon, every Sunday afternoon, grandmother used to just send Kezia down to the drawing room so that he can just have a chat with her parents. But the little girl always found mother reading and father stretched out on the sofa, his handkerchief on his face, his feet on one of the best cushions, sleeping soundly and snoring. So whenever she came down on Sunday, what she used to find that the mother was just busy reading and his father just stretched on sofa, he just cover his face with handkerchief and his feet was just on one of the best cushions and used to just sleep very soundly and he used to just snore. She sat on a stool, gravely watched him until he woke and stretched and asked the time, then looked at her. So the girl used to just sat on a stool and went very seriously. She used to watch him until he woke and stretched and asked the time, then looked at her. Don't stare so, Kezia, you look like a little brown owl. So she used to just sat on a stool and very seriously she used to look him until he woke and asked the time, and she used to just stare her father just like a owl. One day when she was kept indoors with a cold, her grandmother told her that her father's birthday was next week and suggested she should make him a pincushion for a gift out of a beautiful piece of yellow silk. So what happened? One day when she was kept indoors with a cold, I mean she didn't go out because she was suffering from cold, common cold. So her grandmother just told that next week was her father's birthday. So she suggested to make a pin cushion as a gift. Laboriously with a double cotton, the little girl stitched three sides. So laboriously means it's already given here with a lot of effort or difficulty. With a lot of effort or difficulty, the girl had just prepared the, she had just stitched the cloth from the three sides. But what to fill it with, that was the question. The grandmother was out in the garden and she wandered into the mother's bedroom to look for scraps. So she was thinking what to fill in the cushion. So the grandmother was outside and she just slipped into her mother's room and she was looking for some scraps so that she can fill that cushion. On the back table, she discovered a great many sheets of fine paper, gathered them up, tore them into tiny pieces and stuffed her case, then sewed up the fourth side. So she discovered few sheets were there lying on the table. She just tore them into pieces and she put those papers into the cushion and then she sewed it from the fourth side also. That night there was a hue and cry in the house. Hue and cry means angry protested. Something had happened. What had happened? Let's see that why there was so much of angry and protested in the house. Father's great speech for the pot authority had been lost. Rooms were searched, servants questioned. Finally, mother came into Kezia's room. So what happened? That father's great speech was there and that was lost. Okay. So they have just searched in all the rooms. Servants were questioned and afterwards when they didn't get it, mother just entered Kezia's room and she asked her, Kezia, I suppose you didn't see some papers on a table in our room. Oh yes, she said, I tore them up for my surprise. What Kezia told, she didn't thought that those papers were so important. Very innocently she told that yes, she knew very well, she just tore them and she had just put those papers in the to make the pin cushion and for the surprise. What? Screamed mother. Come straight down to the dining room this instant. And she was dragged down to where father was pacing to and fro, hands behind his back. She was dragged down. Father was very much furious, angry, because those were really very important papers for him. Well, he said sharply, mother explained. He stopped and stared at the child. Did you do that? No, she whispered. Mother go up to her room and fetch down the damn thing. She see that the child's put to bed this instant. So she told that no, mother go up to her room and fetch down the damn thing. So she had brought that pin cushion down, okay? See that the child's put to bed this instant. Crying too much to explain, she lay in the shadowed room, watching the evening light make a sad little pattern on the floor. She was just crying and she was just explaining that what she had done. Then father came into the room with the ruler in his hand. Okay, so she was told to go to her room instantly at that time only. Crying too much to explain, means she was crying too much that she was not able to explain why she had done this. She lay in the shadowed room watching the evening light make a sad little pattern on the floor. So she was just lying there and she was looking how the light was just making a very sad pattern on the floor. The father just entered his room with the ruler. I am going to beat you for this, he said. Oh no, no, she screamed, hiding under the bed clothes. So father told her he is going to beat for this mistake. She just screamed, she says no, no, and she just tried to hide herself. He pulled them aside. Sit up, he ordered, and hold out your hands. You must be taught once and for all not to touch what does not belong to you. But it was for your birthday. Down came the ruler on her little pink palms. Hours later, when grandmother had wrapped her in a shawl and rocked her in the rocking chair, the child clung to her soft body. Okay, so father just bitten her with the ruler and the grandmother, as everyone's grandmother, just tried to rescue. She just wrapped her in a shawl and she just make her sit in the rocking chair with her, and the child just cling to the grandmother. Thank you.